Hey guys, and welcome to another tutorial from Tutorial Grid. I am your host, Cherokee, and this is going to be one of our quick and simple tutorials. We are going to be working with just a few separate layers. This is going to be another one that's going to take, 10, 15, 20 minutes to create. This is going to be more of like a James Bondish thing. So it looks pretty cool. But first, make sure to hit that subscribe button on the side of your YouTube for more awesome tutorials coming up, as well as check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/avidproductions479. Like us there to keep up to date with everything that we're doing. Also, check us out on Twitter at twitter.com/tutorialgrid. And this is brought to you in part by SiteGround, where you can get all your awesome web hosting needs with a free domain starting at $3.99. Make sure to check those guys out and get your domain services there. Cool. So we're going to be working in After Effects, and this is kind of what we're going to be creating. And this is what it is. So I play it back. We've got this blood soaking down through our background tissue here, as well as, if you can see, we have a background that's further in the back than our text. So it looks like this is cut out of our foreground texture, and we have this bleeding in, and we've got a light refraction right here. So that's pretty cool. Very simple to make, very quick. And it's more of like a James Bondish, I guess, kind of look. Cool. So there's only a few layers that we're going to need. And let's get started. Okay, so first let's go to composition, new composition. Now I know that this is going to be roughly about 7 seconds. So I'm gonna make sure that's going to be about 7 seconds, but you can do it however long you need it to. I'm gonna start out with my resolution being full, 23.976, and that should be good. Hit okay. So first off, you can use any background or foreground textures. Now to get the bleeding effect as if it's soaking through cloth, you're going to want somewhat of a light texture. I would include this in the download package, but this is not a free download. This is something that I have found and purchased. So make sure you have the rights to your footage before you start playing with it. Anyway, so I've got this cool texture, and you can use whatever you like. Make sure it's fairly light because you're gonna want to make sure that that thing soaks through. And so it's fairly large, which is good because I'm gonna be zooming in and zooming out of camera. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is, or the second thing is, we're gonna type in our text. So I'm gonna type in tutorial grid. Yay, that's us. All right, I'm gonna place it right on top of there, and I don't like that font at all. That isn't tutorial grid. That doesn't, why does that not look right? Did I spell it right? Tutorial grid. Yeah, I spelled it right. Okay, anyway, I don't like the font. So let's just kind of change the font here. I want something bold. Something bold. That'll work right there. Well, maybe not. All right, we'll just use standard impact. How about that? All right, fairly simple. Everybody has it. We'll call it good right there. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to make sure that this layer, these two layers, are going to correspond with each other, and we're going to cut the tutorial grid out of our foreground layer here. So we want to make sure that this is set to white. So we'll go ahead and put that to white. And I believe you can do this two different ways, but I'm going to make sure that I'm going to do it this way. So the first thing we're going to do is take our white construction paper layer right here, and under track mat, select none and then Luma inverted. And that's going to cut out our tutorial grid font from our background. Okay. So now we have our, I guess, logo, or you could say your text, cut out of your foreground layer. So the next thing we're going to do is we have another texture that we're going to place into our scene. And we're going to take this and place it underneath our white construction paper. Now you see that goes underneath and it looks as though this is in 3D space so far. So we have this underneath our layer here. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to check our 3D boxes here. Now, if you just check them and leave it that way, they're all going to be on this exact same layer, and we don't want that, or the exact same place in 3D space. So what we're going to want to do is select this background layer and push that in the back. We want it fairly far back there, because whenever we move our camera, it's going to make it that much more noticeable that we're making a camera move. So I'm going to keep this fairly small, because actually maybe just a little bit bigger. A little bigger right there. Okay. So whenever I move the camera, it's going to make a huge movement rather than a small one. So the next thing we're going to do is I've got these really cool ink splatters, which they're just absolutely fantastic. Whoops, go here. They're wonderful. They're in 4K. They are just absolutely the bomb. Like, I would recommend them to everyone because they're just cool. And you can download those from Mitch Martinez 4K or MitchMartinez.com. So they are free, so no worries there. They are very, very free. You just have to go and download them. They're free for corporate use and all that stuff. The guy's awesome. Gives stuff away for free, just kind of like we do. So make sure to get those there if you're wanting this ink splatter. So this is the one I'm going to use, is this ink 3. So I'm going to bring that down onto my tutorial grid layer here. Okay. But I'm going to make... Okay. I don't want the third one. Never mind. I don't want number 3. I think I want 25. That might be it. Because I know it's the one that comes in from the top. All right. That's it right there. Cool. Okay. So I'm going to scale this down. All right. So that blends and bleeds right on through. Cool. And I'm also going to have to offset this quite a bit. So the first thing you're going to notice is we've got a lot of white and black. Now, we don't want the white at all. The easiest way to do that is to select under your effects and presets, invert. Bring that on top of the ink layer. Okay. And then we're also going to type in unmult. Now, Unmold is a free download from Red Giant Software, so make sure to go get that as well. So that's going to bring us a white layer here. Now, the next thing we're going to do is type in saturation and drag our saturation on top of our layer. And make sure to select this little box that says colorize. Now, this is going to color our white footage here. So we're going to boost up our saturation quite a bit and turn down the lightness. That's going to give us our color of the blood, or whatever you're going to call it, that's going to seep through this thing. Cool. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to select the mode. And I believe what I was using was overlay, which that is obviously wrong. So if that is wrong for what you're using, you can select or hold down shift and hit plus and minus, and you can flow through all the different blending modes. So I'm not liking any of those. That doesn't look good. That right there. Linear burn is going to be my friend today. All right, so linear burn is going to be what I'm going to use. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select the tutorial grid layer here, duplicate that, select it on top of my Ink 25, and I'm going to do that same track matting. So go ahead and select the track mat under Ink 25 and make sure it's Luma Inverted Matte. So now we have that directly above, or that cuts out our footage here. Okay. Okay, so that's looking good. So now the next thing that we're going to do is I'm going to go to Layer, New Camera. Select that camera, and that's going to change everything. All right, so we are going to select the background layer here and make sure and squeeze that up pretty good. Now, I'm noticing something weird here, which shouldn't be happening, which is that right there. There we go. That works. Cool. So you got to make sure your camera's all the way up on top. My mistake. So we've got this cool bleeding effect. Very quick, very simple. And so we've got the camera. So I'm going to go ahead and make a camera move. So we'll hit P for position. And we'll hit the position tool right here. Make sure your keyframe is selected. And move to the end of our composition. And we're just going to move this in. All right, and you also want to make sure that the Ink 25 is checked for 3D. And just move the camera in. So we'll go ahead and select that about right there. And I'm going to move this out quite a bit. So I'm going to start my composition about right there. I'm also going to check on my Ink 25 and push this up quite a bit. About right there. And I'm going to actually have this come in quite a bit later. So I'm going to move this in here. And make this a little bigger. Yeah, so we'll start that off there. It's going to be moving in really, really slow. And then when it comes in, it's going to start to bleed in. Cool. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add an adjustment layer. So I'm going to go to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer. And I'm actually going to bring this adjustment layer on top of my tutorial grid layer because I don't want it to affect my blood. Actually, I don't want it to affect my blood. So I'm going to type in exposure. And this is going to give more of like a vignette feel, but it's not going to be a vignette. Whoops, placed it on the wrong layer. All right, color correction. Adjustment layer right there. I'm just going to bring this down quite a bit. I'm also going to play with my gamma. Bring that down as well. I'm also going to select my effects and presets curves. Make sure that that is very, very contrasty. All right, right there. And I'm going to select my ellipse tool, double click on that, make sure my mask is set to subtract, hit F, and feather this out. Okay, I'm also going to select T for opacity. I'm going to bring it down just a little bit. It's going to just add a little bit into that composition. So now we have a vignette around our tutorial grid logo here. We've got it flying in real close. We've got our blood seeping through our logo here, looking really menacing. I might turn my opacity down just a bit more because that's really kind of saturating the crap out of it there. Okay, do that. So that is just about it, actually. It's very quick and simple. The last thing that we can add is we had a small little flare or a little bit of a light refraction, which we'll add that. We'll go back into our project here, which is going to be this SL-3. Now, we have a bunch of light refractions and light artifacts for download on our website at avidproductions479.com. So if you go to avidproductions479.com/light artifacts, you can download the free sample. We're actually coming out with a 4K, 1080p, and Photoshop overlay light artifact package. So make sure to get the free sample there so you can use a couple of those in your projects. And I'm just going to go ahead and select my SL3 layer and bring that down on top of my camera here. And it looks like that's going to look fairly good right there. So I'm going to start it about right here. And again, I'm going to select or hold down shift and use my plus and minus keys to change my blending modes. I'm going to see which one works best for me. That actually looks pretty cool. That's a little much. That is not enough. That is... Actually, that's just soft enough that I like it. Bring that in there. Cool. All right, that looks good. Looks really good. Cool, cool. Well, that is a quick and simple tutorial as well. What I wanted to show you is right here in the center. If you look, you can see our background just moves ever so slightly, and it's just going to add to that 3D effect. So we've added our lights. We've got the blood dripping. We've got everything working for us. You can turn your curves down just a little bit on the background if you want to, just to kind of give it more of an edge. Maybe give it some, a little bit of color. Yeah, maybe a little bit of color there. Cool. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this quick and simple tutorial. My name is Cherokee, and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube. Also, check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/avidproductions479. Also, check us out at Twitter at twitter.com/tutorialgrid. Also, download our new packages, our free download package at avidproductions479.com. This is also brought to you by SiteGround for great web hosting and a free domain for your first year at $3.99. Make sure to check them out. Description is in the, or the link is in the description. So make sure to check those guys out. It's been fun, and I will see you next.